Hey guys, my name is Aditya and today I'm going to be reading this book called Marmaduke the Very Popular Dragon. It is written by Rachel Valentine and illustrated by Ed Eves. So let's start. Marmaduke the Very Popular Dragon. Marmaduke and Meg were different, brilliantly, happily different. They were best friends and they were always together, practicing whiz-cone, having adventures or sneaking off to the secret spot on Wispy Mountain. Everyone else would see what would watch Marmaduke and Meg. They wished they could have that much fun, but the princesses sat in the towers and the dragon stood guard, because that's how it had always been until one day when Princess decided to be brave. Princess October walked quietly up to Marmaduke and Meg. "Could I play with you?" she whispered. "Absolutely," said Marmaduke. And soon October was having more fun than she'd ever had. Slowly, slowly, the word spread across the kingdom. First, the other princesses joined in. Then the princes, then even the knights. The kingdom became a happy place. Marmaduke had never had friends before apart from Meg. But now everyone loved him and his amazing wings. It felt wonderful being so popular, and he was always busy helping Orky with fire breathing, Toadstool snuffling with Princess Penny, teaching Wisconsin to Prince Bertie. Meg barely saw a friend, but she was pleased that Marmaduke was so happy. The king had decided all the Wisconsin tournament teams for near and far would battle for the Golden Wisconsin Cup. Each team had a dragon and a rider, perfect for the best friends like Marmaduke and Meg. Soon, preparations for the tournament began. There was great excitement as the gardens were strung from tree to tree and banners flown high. But as Meg sat alone, watching the royal flag being raised, she thought sadly it would have been much more fun to watch with Marmaduke. She decided to look for him. Marmaduke wasn't in his cave. He wasn't at the toy shop or even at the ice cream parlor. "I know," thought Meg. "Wispy Mountain." She skipped to the secret place, but as she got closer, she heard voices. Marmaduke was there with Princess Bertie, who was laughing. "Thanks for asking me to be your partner, Marmaduke. I'm so excited about the Wisconsin tournament." "Me too," said Marmaduke. Meg gasped. She and Marmaduke always played together. He seemed to be forgetting about her. Before they could see, Meg crept away. At last, it was the Wisconsin tournament, and the whole kingdom had come to watch. The gong boomed. The pine cone was flung and the games began. Riders whipped the cone from their rivals and hurled it through goals. Dragons spun and drove, the crowd roared, "Marmaduke, Marmaduke, Marmaduke." He was the favorite and he had Bertie for playing brilliantly. But Meg found she didn't want to watch them scoring goal after goal. Quietly, sadly, she slipped away. The Wisconsin tournament team battled all afternoon until the final gong. And the winner were announced. In first place with 55 goals was Marmaduke and Prince Bertie. Grinning, they collected the enormous Wisconsin Cup. Everyone crowded around congratulating them and cheering, and Marmaduke should have been happy, except something was missing. Suddenly he realized Meg was missing. Marmaduke wriggled away from the clouds and pricked up his enormous ears from far away when he heard the sound of swarming. Meg, he called, soaring into the sky, but as he flew towards the sobs, Marmaduke had a very uncomfortable thought. "I have not been a good friend to Meg. I haven't spent any time with her." Then he gulped, and I left her out of the tournament. From up high, Marmaduke spotted Meg sitting alone on Wispy Mountain. He dived down. "I'm really sorry, Meg. I was so busy with my new friends, I forgot about my best friend." "I did feel left out," said Meg, quietly wiping away a tear. "I'll never ever do that again," Marmaduke promised. scrunching her in a huge hug. From that day, Marmaduke kept his promise. No matter how many friends he had, Meg and Marmaduke always tried his hardest to be a good friend. And a good friend being Meg is the very best thing in the world. I read the book. Don't forget to subscribe and leave a like to my channel. Bye!